Hello, I'm glad you're tuned in to my station. And again, welcome to the Artistic Talent Show. My name is Melvin Isaac, and I am an artist. You can always visit me at www.artistictalentinc.web.com. There you will see various of exhibits and, of course, portrait art that you can purchase. You can always let me know whenever you want a portrait art, and I can come back to you and tell you the details of it, the amount, and the time that it would take. It's all on my website, so just go to my website, visit it, support me. Support the things that I'm doing for the young people in the community to build their life, to reach out and find their hidden talent where they can start doing something positive for themselves and for their community. Okay, so I'm going to let y'all get back to the my art exhibit, and I will come back to close this out. And thank you again for visiting me, for visiting my website, for visiting my art that you see. And remember, I'm on air every Thursday at 6 p.m. at Time Warner 67. And you can go to the internet at www.bcat.tv. And that's the Brooklyn Community Access Television Community. And I am a certified producer for Brooklyn Access Community, which is called BCAP. So watch me, watch the show, support me, support the things that I'm doing. And I welcome you to come on my show, or even visit my website, or even be a producer as well. So if you have your talent out there, this is the way to go. Again, come back, visit me, and I thank you again for watching my show. Bye.
Hi, we're Infinite Angels, and you are watching the Artistic Talent Show.
Okay, we're going to be talking about my art, promotion of my art. And I want to show you different various stages of my drawing. One of the stages is the pencil drawing. Now, this right here is a pencil drawing, and this is dancers. Now, this is a very nice pencil drawing that one could get, and the price for this is only $35 for a pencil drawing of this kind. Over here is another stage, which is a medium, is oil painting. Now, this is a picture that I took of a king's outfit, and around 15 years ago, I put my face in a picture of a king's outfit. This, I always put this in the shows because I always like to carry myself around, because this shows leadership, royalty, and it shows something about yourself. This oil painting sold for $900. Soon it came on the show, and it took first prize. And then you go over here to this other part where you have another portrait joint of myself, and that's in colored pencil. And that still is $35. Now, these cards that I did, which is greeting cards, and these cards right here, and I want to get a little closer to it where you can see it, but these cards are drawings that I have did. Now, greeting cards is only $3. And it comes with the envelope as well. So anytime you want to purchase a greeting card, it's $3. But when you get a drawing, a portrait drawing from me, which is something like that, I would include a greeting card of the same portrait for yourself. So you're getting an extra. You're getting a portrait for $35, and you would also get a greeting card
for nothing. So the greeting card is free with the portrait drawing. As long as you're buying a portrait drawing, you get a free greeting card with your picture in it. But if you're buying it separate, it would be $3. These art that I'm doing is presenting them to you, the public, to purchase. And the reason why I'm doing this, again, because of I formed an organization, non-for-profit, called the Artistic Talent. And this is to help transform, change young people's lives around. And I'm selling these arts right here in order to raise money to help them, to build the organization. So we really reaching out to you to buy these art, to purchase these art, to help us to help out the young people. And we really appreciate either your donation or buying a purchase piece of this art as you've seen already. If you want a portrait that you've seen that we had over here, a portrait drawing, you can call me directly at 646-784-3902 and we will set up a time and a place to do your portrait, and you will have a perfect portrait. So you can do it either way. If you want a portrait, you can call me at 646-784-3902. And if you want to email me at my email address, that would be mis718@yahoo.com. I thank you very much for your time and also for you listening to what we are doing to help out young people turn their lives around. Thank you very much.
And I'm a huge fan of Melvin's.
And where we are.
And we're at a Hudson Link art exhibit. And it's extraordinary works of art that are around here that's been done by some very talented people. Okay, and while I'm speaking, Melvin is drawing beside me. And Melvin's just one of my favorite folks, and he's really, really extraordinary talent. There are lots of people here, and they seem to be having a wonderful time, and I can understand that too. And Hudson Link has sponsored this art exhibit. Hopefully it'll be something that they'll do periodically, because obviously there's beautiful art to see and there are wonderful people to visit with. So I certainly think that folks should come and enjoy this kind of an experience that both is sponsored by Hudson Link and that is also done by people who have really developed their talent in extraordinary ways. Melvin Isaac is one that we got to know a while ago, and Melvin is a good buddy and someone that we think can do all sorts of things. As a matter of fact, we have some artwork of Melvin's at our home as well that he did years ago. And it's a wonderful refreshment table, and folks are having a lot of fun, and I'm pleased to be here. It's a real treat to be here. And it's a real treat to see some of the men that I haven't seen for quite a while, and to have a chance to see again the pictures that Melvin has done. I saw the praying hands in the corridor there. It's just amazing. I understand that hands are particularly difficult to draw, and yet he does that so beautifully. Evidently, that is a part of the anatomy that is very hard to get look realistic and look human and all the rest of it. He's done that. But I think Melvin's very good at catching the human component in whatever he does. And that's reflected in a lot of the pieces that I've seen here. And I'm not sure what else would be of interest to others. I know there's a lot here that's of interest to me, both the artwork and the people. And this gentleman is beside me working industriously. And folks are wandering around and studying the things on the easels, and there were some lovely speeches earlier that people talked about their various relationships. I know John Valverde spoke because he was one of the originators of the Hudson Link mission. I'm trying to think how far we go back since I've known Melvin. Melvin, do you answer that question? How long have I known you?
You've known me for, over a couple of centuries.
Decades. Can I interview Melvin while I'm here?
Yes, you could.
I can interview Melvin. Okay.
You can ask me any kind of questions.
Great. I would love to interview Melvin. Okay, so...
So I welcome you to go to museums, art galleries, bring a sketch pad out and start sketching the scenery. You got a huge amount of scenery that nature has out there, and just start sketching. That will get you in the start of your hidden inner talent. And that would make you a real, to me, you know, laid back, you know, person that is see the world through your eyesight, which is your perspective in art, and it gives you another way of looking at life and another way of expressing yourself. Now, there is one place that I would know of that we can, build on this information I just recently got. And it's called Free Fulfillment. So let me repeat that again. I need someone or a volunteer that would help me build this organization, which is non-for-profit, to help out the community. And one of the information that I just received lately is in order to get funding, it's called Free Fulfillment, and it's already designed to tell you which way to go. And they do help out non-for-profit organization that is trying to help out the community. So if anyone out there that would like to put in some time to help me build the organization through art, please contact me at 646-784-3902. My name is Melvin Isaac again. I'm an artist and a BCAP producer. Please contact me at 646-784-3902 because I do need assistance. I do need someone that will support me, support the community, and help me build this wonderful, wonderful art organization for the community. And it's through this information I just received. It's called Free Fulfillment, which is a funding source. It's a funding company that is already designed to help people out that's non-for-profit. And they already, you just follow the procedure. I just need someone to help me into that funding so this way we can build this organization together. I really appreciate if somebody could do that with me. Another thing that I want to point out is soon, I'm going to put up when it's going to happen, but very soon, the summer's just about here, and I'm going to be doing my own art exhibit. So I have plenty of arts, a lot of stuff that I'm going to be doing. Of course, I will have somebody sit there and I would actually draw you a portrait picture. If you cannot, I can take a picture of yourself and do the drawing and give you the sketch later on. And this is all free. I'm just promoting the art, promoting myself, and and selling the art, but the person that sits there will get a free art. So I will share with you later on. You just look, keep watching my show, look at the website, and I will put up the date and time that I would start doing my exhibit, my art exhibit, which I'm gonna call it an art gallery, Melvin's Art Gallery. So it will be coming up soon, and I'm sure you will enjoy it. It are pictures. I even will have pictures that's on a card. You know, a lot of black art that's on a greetings card, and also a regular card. And if a person is sitting there, I would also put your picture on a greetings card as well. So it's gonna be really nice. And some of my artwork, as you're gonna see after you finish hearing me talking, I will show you some of those cards that you will see that's already laid out, and then you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. It's gonna be fantastic, beautiful. I'm pretty sure you would love it, you know. So watch out, keep watching the show, because you will see when I will do my art exhibit and where it will be at and what.
Hi everybody, my name is Dionysia Ruz. I'm doing real good in school right about now. I get A's and B's. My GPA average is 3.8, and now, right about now in life, I'm still going through my troubles. With my troubles, I came upon a group called U-Turn. Right now, I'm with Brother Isaac. He's showing me how to go through life, because through life, it has the trials. As the trials, you have to face them and try to move on. Everybody, in a way, have a way to express their anger and how they feel. The way I express my anger is by writing poems. If there's not a way that you can express yourself during poems, everybody should find their own special way, if it's singing, rapping, dancing, anything, to express themselves. Today, I guess I'll be showing you some of my poems and express how I feel, because right about now, I'm going through my things with friends, boys, everything. So I'm starting off with my first poem. The first poem, I wrote it, well, it was starting off with this morning when I was just angry and I decided to write. As I wrote, the first poem is, when I think about how badly people hurt me, I feel to hurt them back. When I think about how people betrayed me, I feel to betray them back. But life moves on, and as it moves on, it makes me a stronger and better person. It's amazing how life is. As two doors shut in my face, two doors be open and let two special people into my life. The first person is a guy that brings me up and not down. He helps me to relieve my anger and let me see who I really am. And his name is Brother Isaac. I have a second poem too. Right about now, I'm kind of going through things with my friends. Well, I thought she was my friend, but I guess I was wrong, you know? Like, there's always that special person that you think will be by your side or be down for you, but then they always end up changing. But not always, but in my situation, the girl did change. Well, let's see, when I wrote this one. Well, this one kind of goes towards my friend that I wrote like roughly a week ago. It says, I thought you was my friend until you betrayed me. I thought you was my ride or die chick, the only one I'll do anything for. Thought you was my girl I could pick up for if anything go down. I thought you was my baby, the one that I could say that I could pick up for when shit really goes down. But now I really see who you are. After 10 years, I thought you was my girl. You're not the person that I saw you as. You're not the person you're supposed to be to me. I think I was blinded by your love, or maybe more our friendship. I thought you was my friend, my ride or die chick, my girl, my baby. And you know what? I came to the fact that I was wrong. Well, this is another poem that I wrote. As I was going through everything with my mother, my friends, and everybody, my family, and everything, I just decided to write this one. Well, today is May 5th, and I wrote this one on May 2nd. I try to live life to the fullest, but it seems as if my life is going down. I try to move on and forget the people who hurt me in every way, but it seems as if there's a wall blocking me in front. I try to break it down. It seems as if It doesn't want to be broken. This wall can't be seen because it's inside of me, blocking every side of my heart. When I look at the people who have hurt me in every way, the hate that I have towards them become more intense day by day. But I still want to break this wall down and stop putting the stress on people. I want to break this wall down so my family can love me the way they used to. But it seems as if the streets are calling my name, like, you know, like they're my best friends, because I don't have no family to back me up. I want my mom, especially, to love me the way she used to, but the hate I have towards her won't allow her to love me the way she used to. But I try so hard, but it's just this wall that's just blocking me and blocking me from society. Well, this is my last poem for right now, but you see, all my poems just has to really do with life and everything that I go through during the day and night, anytime you want to consider it. Well, it's amazing how life has its ups and downs and its ins and outs. One moment life will be the best, and one quick moment it'll change.
I have a model. I have a new model, and her name is Dionysia. And so she will be with me, and she probably one of my permanent models. She does poetry, and y'all already heard her already. So now it's time for art. So the first thing I'm going to do is start off with our basic principle of drawing a person. And actually, I'm going to look at her. I'm going to do a portrait of her starting from here. And we're going to start off like that. And then next week, I will do a full figure. So today it was going to be part of the four basic shapes that I'm doing with her. All right, and then I want to show you the four basic shapes. So let's start off with our drawing.
With Corey, we're standing here in Fulton Mall. Corey, can you tell us where you're from?
Brooklyn.
Brooklyn, okay, are you familiar with freestyle art?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we have here Melvin Isaac. He's a freestyle artist, and he's gonna do this lovely lady right over here. Would you buy something like this?
I would like to see it first, see what he can do.
Okay, would you want to spectate it?
Okay.
Do you have a few minutes?
Yes, I do.
Okay, thanks a lot.
This story is very intricate because I'm seeing art. I'm telling you about art the way I see it through my eyesight. Now, how I get this particular information is because I follow the old masters. You're going to be seeing some of the pictures that she's holding up right now before I start to draw her. But some of the old masters is like Leon da Vinci, Pablo Picasso. You heard this famous Norman Rockwell. And one of the things that I'm going to be using is Daniel Green method of drawing a perspective. The way I'm going to have her draw is going to go through the portion of length. And you will see her quick the way I would do it. But the first thing I want to do is talk about the art while I'm drawing the perspective of her. So this art right here that I'm talking about is the Black Queens of Africa. Now, these are the Black Queens that you want to see. And this is us. These are the sisters that you see out here in the world. So this is the Black Queen of Africa. The bunch of colors that you see, it shows a lot of movement in the painting, which is showing movement and a life. So it's sort of like a life, a real lively picture because of the colors. Right here, this is a drawing. And what this is African drums. And to go back into perspective, into our history, this is what we knew because we told our stories. We actually gave signals, and we tell you if anybody else is coming into the neighborhood, and we actually play our music. All of this is through our drums. So actually, we're talking to you through drums. And this is where we started at before we came to come to this country.
And you say Paris City. And you say New York City. Jazz Liberators with the Live Motivator. Check it out, y'all. Yeah, from the five to the mind to the hand to the pen to transcribe the plan, to stick to fly paper but never quite land at my last destination. From bus, train, or plane to radio station, I occupy minds, that's my occupation. My childhood to baptism, indoctrination, all the way through to my high education. Reward for my patience, I'm loving my calling, calling my loved ones from extra long distance across many seas. I wish y'all were here, the things that we'd see, the witness I bear, as light as hot air. But since you're not here, I lay your foundation that brings me back with you, reward for your patience. You can say I'm working on a vacation. You can say, you can say, you can say,
you can say,
you can say, and you say New York City.
You can say,
you should say,
you can say,
a matter of fact, you can say I'm working on a vacation. You can say,
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 right now,
it'd be true,
right here,
you should say,
just say,
you can say,
you can say,
you can say, I'm working on your vacation.
As time flies by, the calendar changes, months, days, and years, add-ons, rearrangements, there's so much divine, but ain't nothing sacred, we can't turn the clock back, so why try and fake it? I grow with the movement, but still I stand, and retrace the steps we crawled, walked, and ran. I look forward to a vintage, spit over jazz riffs to choose ancient strings over synthage. The mood the beat brings, pluck at your heartstrings. So for now I choose words that won't harm ya, disarm ya, to slide off the armor. Let your mind ponder on things that calm ya, then let it wander, way past beyond the stress that your life brings, things that frustrate ya, getting all